world of pure imagination. Take a look and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in a world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, take a look around and view it. Anything you want to do it. Want to change the world? There's nothing to it. There is no life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be. So this is my very first diary. I got it in 2008 when I was just 7 years old. And I thought that it would be particularly fitting to feature my first ever diary in the opening number of my first cabaret, Dear Diary. If you want to view paradise, take a look around and view it. Anything you want to do it. Want to change the world? There's nothing to it. There is no life I know to compare. Tonight, supporting myself and my three fellow incredible performers in the beautiful Sutton Pavilion. My name is gorgeous. Never seen it looking like this before. My name is Alex Kafrissen, and I am so excited to welcome you to my show, Dear Diary, directed by the incredible Kathleen Wrinn. By the brilliant Harry Castle. So this show, you guys are really in for it tonight. This show is full of real entries from all of my personal diaries, ranging ages 6 to 22. Oh, wow. So before I start diving into the next 15 years or so of my life in this stack of 12 diaries behind me, I just want you to raise your hand. I'm trying to get a sense of how many of you have ever kept a diary. Amazing, oh my God. Or even done the, keep your hands up, or done the occasional journal entry. Or even pre-planned a text with your friends in the notes section of your phone. Yeah. Okay, keep your hands up. So out of this group, a fun question, who would like to come up to the front and read something from their notes section? Okay. No volunteers. Yeah. Maybe later. Well, I have always loved journaling my entire life. And when I was in elementary school, I would run up to my room at night and sit on my bed until I was sure that my parents and my brother were no longer awake. And I would write until I fell asleep. The girl pretends she's a maiden fair in her story. She wears the moon in her flowing hair. In her story, her suitors exit and enter. She creates their plights, and she rules the world. She writes. A suitor comes in a strange disguise. In her story, he says he is noble by birth. He lies. In her story, but she can see that he's brilliant. That his eyes hold nuts. She makes him king of the world, she writes. We walked in moonlight and talked of plays like a story. And he fell deep in her moonlit gaze like a story. I played the beautiful maiden, and his eyes held lights. A girl discovers, as far as lovers, she rules the world, she writes. So, this next book comes with a warning. It's top secret. It's called The Dating Book. And now, before I really crack open The Dating Book, you are all going to have to take the dating book oath, which is a real oath that I wrote and that I made my friends take before they wanted to read the dating book. Mm. Please repeat after me. Mm. I state your name.
I state your name.
Swear on my love life.
Swear on my love life.
That I will never speak to anyone.
That I will never speak to anyone.
About the info found in this book.
About the info found in this book.
So help me God, we're just kidding. January 25th, 2010. Walker, my new boyfriend, invited me to watch a movie with him. It was so romantic, with a CK. I thought, T-H-O-T, actually invented the word. I thought he would put his RM around me. It felt like we were on a date. I love Walker. Honey, 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 throaty, honey, honey. Honey, honey, nearly kills me, honey, honey. I've heard about you before. Now I wanted to know some more. I feel like I'm gonna scream. Ah! He's a love machine. Oh, it makes me dizzy. February 27th, 2010. I found out Walker is at my lunch table. It's so hot how he stares at me with those big, dreamy eyes. I feel like I'm about to melt. But there he is at my lunch table, sitting with another girl. I was cheated by you. So I made up my mind, it must come to an end. Look at me now, will I ever learn? I don't know how, but I suddenly lose control. There's a fire within my soul. Just one look and I can hear a bell ring. One more look and I forget everything. Whoa, Mamma Mia, here I go again. My, my, how can I resist you? Mamma Mia, does it show again? My, my, just how much I missed you. Yeah, so good, broken hearted, blue since the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go? Mamma Mia, now I really know. My, my, I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every woman I see is a potential threat. Now all possessive, it isn't nice. You've heard me saying that that time was my only thoughts. But now it isn't true. Now everything is new. And all I've learned is overturned. I beg of you. Wasting your emotion. Lay your love on me. Don't go sparing your devotion. Lay your love on me. March 3rd, 2010. Today I'm feeling annoyed. N-O-I-E-D. I don't have a crush on Walker anymore because he pushed me at gym. Yeah, he's a jerk. And I am so done with boys forever. I don't want to talk about the things we've gone through. Though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I've played all my cards. My favorite was Go Fish. That's what you've done too. Nothing more to say. No more ace to play. The winner takes it all. The loser standing small. Beside the victory, that's our destiny. The winner takes it all. The loser standing small. Beside the victory, that's her destiny. I will never love again. March 20th, 2010. A new boy named Robert just sat at my lunch table. Honey, honey. Honestly, I didn't really think about it before I started writing this show, but there is just an unlimited number of men at your disposal when you're nine. They're everywhere, and they don't know how to brush their teeth yet. But now we're in high school. Yeah. And imagine this, it's a Friday night. You just got out of rehearsal for the big school musical, Spring Awakening. Yeah, the school musical. Fully clothed, no sex, no kiss. And you are about to go on that date, finally, with that brilliant senior that you've been in love with for all about 2 months now. January 30th, 2018. Andrew and I went on our first date this past weekend, and it was amazing, and I had so much fun. But apparently, he didn't really describe it to our friends as a date. Maybe he is just so scared to mess anything up, because he just cares about me that much. In the midst of this nothing, this mess of a life, still there's this one thing, just to see you go by. It's almost like loving, sad as that is. May not be cool, but it's so where I live. No, it's long gone, and the magic's not here no more. And it might be okay, but I'm not find it all. Cause there we are again in that little town street. Almost ran the red cause you were looking over at me. Wind in my hair, I was there. I remember it all too well. Photo album on the counter. Your cheeks are turning red. You used to be a little kid with glasses and a twin-sized bed. And your mom was telling stories about you on the T-ball team. You told me about your past, thinking your future was me. Get ready. And you were tossing me the car keys.
Fuck the patriarchy!
Yeah, keep Jane on the ground. You were always skipping town. And I was thinking on the drive down any time now. He's gonna say it's never called it what it is. And I lie back just drifting and play all these scenes. I ride on the rush, all the hopes, all the dreams. I may be neglecting
the things I should do. But we've all got our junk, and my junk is you. So I still keep talking after you're gone. You're still with me, but feel so good in my arms. They tell you go blind. Baby, it's true. But we've all got our junk, and my junk is you. You call me up again just to break me like a promise. So casually cruel in the name of being honest. I'm a crumbled up piece of paper lying here. You don't remember it all. It's like we stopped time. Maybe it's true. We've all got a junk, and my junk is you. My junk is you. You remember it all. You remember it all. I remember it all too well.
That absolute ride. I started applying to college and I was more than ready for a change. Now, don't get me wrong, college absolutely is a fresh start. I mean, you can completely reinvent yourself, create all new friendships, and finally study what you're really passionate about. But the boys. I mean, they're still like, what, 18? They're like toddlers. And you want more than they can give, but something feels better than nothing, right? So you settle. You're just as 18 as they are. And it's really hard to raise your standards when you don't know your own. April 18th, 2021. In the back of my mind, I always know that we aren't exclusive. I want him to want me more than anyone else, but I don't know if I can keep his attention in a room full of pretty girls. Maybe what we have now can be enough for me if I still get you. I could be casual for you. I could be anything for you. I can play the mistress of the senator. Stash me in a comfortable high-rise that's convenient to the hill. And after making some speech or signing some bill, you'll drop in for lunch. And if you never take lunch with me around, you will. I'll play advisor to the congressman. That's a role that takes a lot of soul to do. I'll be useful down in Washington. I'll be anything like you. I need a change of scenery. I need a new career. I need a new adventure. And I can't wait another year. I can't wait another day. Not when I have you. You need to win important races. I need to play in better places. Let me play the lover. I'll be president. Son of a wing of the White House. And we can share the swimming pool. You'll let me decide who's on her cool, important or not, friend or fool. I'll play Lady Bird, Rosalind, Pat. I'll play Jackie better than Jackie did and not use a hat. I'll play the good wife, the martyr, the asset, the plus. I'll play myself in the movie of us, in the movie of us, in the movie of us. You need a lover. I'll be your lover. I'll see your lover. Thank you.
I'll be what you want, I'll be anything.
Every week, but it's not so funny when every single journal entry ends the exact same way, no matter where it starts. I've spent so much time relying on the validation of others, and specifically men, that I barely take the time to write or think about what I want. And whether we acknowledge it or not, we all have things like that. A pattern that feels impossible to break. But is there a point where this changes? Or are these the patterns that we stay in forever? Patterns in my life that I trace every day. Patterns as I say the things I always say. Patterns in the ceiling as I lie awake. Why are patterns haunting every move I make? Just look, here I am on cue again, upset, feeling torn in two again, afraid, saying I'm okay, making little jokes till I run away again. And yet I know I am not the same. I feel my mind splitting from its frame. Strange feelings rise, feelings with no name, and I can't face them, so I shake them hard. Fold them up and tuck them safely away again. Patterns that begin as I walk through a door. Patterns in the curtains and the kitchen floor. Patterns in the day's routines I must arrange. Patterns in the ways I try. Never change. Just look, as I'm thrown a curve again, I leap, then I lose my nerve again. In tears, running home I go, secretly relieved, safe with what I know again. And yet I know I am not the same. Inside my heart, something I can't tame. His chilling breath bursting into flame. And I must change or else I will break apart. Or break away and end up having to start again. Patterns through the day I seem to use to give my life a shape. Patterns through the house that give me comfort when I need escape. Patterns that lead me nowhere at all. Until we choose to break them. And that is such breaking patterns. Sometimes I wish that I could go back and talk to my younger self from what I know now and tell her to stop letting those external forces dictate the way that she feels about herself. I mean, just wear your freaking magenta rectangular glasses, pink sparkly fedora, colorful braces, side bangs, and a bob all at the same time. Honestly, she was brave. If I could talk to her now, I probably wouldn't be going to her for fashion advice, but I would tell her this.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been and how I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. It's true that I was made for you. I climbed across the mountain tops. I swam across the ocean blue. I crossed all the lines and I broke all the rules. But baby, I broke them all for you. Because even when I was flat broke, you made me feel like you do, and I was made for you.
You see the smile that's on my mouth, it's hiding the words that don't come out.
And all of my friends who think that I'm blessed, they don't know my head is a mess. No, they don't know what I really am. They don't know what I've been through like you do. And I was made for you.
So before I finish this last song of the night, I wanted to take one last moment to thank my incredible director, Kathleen Wrinn. My brilliant accompanist and music director, Carrie Kassel. This night would not have been possible at all. And I want to thank all of you for coming out here tonight. You have no idea how much it means to me and to all of my fellow performers to be able to study what I love and share with the people I love for one last time in this building before I go has been such a privilege, and this is a night and an experience that I can confidently say I will never forget. So before I go and start crying, I thought it'd be particularly fitting to share one last very recent journal entry. December 9th, 2023. In 1 month, I'm moving to New York.
Oh my God.
Everyone I talk to about it tells me, oh my God, you must be so excited. Or I'll miss you, but it's where you're meant to be. And I want to believe them, I do, because that's how I used to feel. You never know when you'll need your younger self most, and I think I need her right now. But I have her with me in these journals. And I get to take her with me wherever I go. And if there's one thing that I've learned from her, from that crazy little girl, it's that you have to be brave enough to go after what you want and brave enough to accept everything you deserve. And if you can't do it for yourself yet, do it for her.
And all of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories. And I'ma get to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. It's true that I was made for you. Oh yeah, it's true. that I was made for.